tell you the user, and backslash D will tell you the database that you are using. For instance, in this case, you have noun as database, you change database, and then it becomes test. Again, in the talking about making your life easier, you can use an alias to simplify your life. So instead of writing many long things in the command line, you can just use an alias. For instance, MySQL as root means MySQL minus minus default file equal and the name of the file. And this will put you inside the database as root. When you use it, you just get yourself in as root, and not only that, you will have a specific prompt that tells you, reminds you that you are root, and makes you think twice before typing dangerous comments. Another useful alias is mybatch, where you can call MySQL with minus B and minus N, so you get only the result without the headers. If you have used the shell before, you know that in addition to aliases, you can also define functions. Function is like an alias, but you can use parameters. One example is this. You can create a function grant now, and then inside the function you accept 1, 2, 3, and 4 parameters, and use these parameters inside the command that you are using. So grant now, select on world.star John and John secret will expand into grant, select on world.star to John identified by John secret. In this case, you can easily create a new user as root. And this is a demonstration that the thing works. Another thing that is not specific to the command line but is useful if you are playing with MySQL a lot is getting query details. If you are executing a lot of commands from a file and you get a mistake, you get an error, then you need to know how to identify the error. For example, this simple script, 4 lines, has one mistake. When you execute it, it tells you unknown column A. What is the error and why it was called? If you want to know, you just say MySQL minus V and execute the script. And then, in addition to executing it, it will also show you what is executing. Then it becomes simpler to see. This is the line that doesn't work, and it tells you that in this line, there is unknown column A. So you realize what it's talking about, and you can fix it. Another thing that you can do with a MySQL client, in matter of getting more information, is getting the execution time. The execution time, instead of doing verbose once, you do verbose twice. And at the end, it tells you how long it takes to execute this command. Notice that if you do this in batch mode, it doesn't tell you the time. So if you are in batch mode, you have to do 3 verbose to get also the time. Small details that can save you time later on. Now, back to the command line, how to get distinct results. What is a distinct result? Let's see an example here. I query the database to get the port number. and I get four things: variable name, value, so this is the header, and the variable name is port and the value is 3306. Actually, this is too much. I just want this. I want to get 3306. How do I do that? If I use minus n minus b, can you see that? Because from here it doesn't show very well. I can only get 3306, actually port and 3306. So there is something more here. I don't want port, I just want 3306. So there are two ways of doing that. If you are from the old school and you have never heard of Perl, of course you wouldn't be in this room in this case, and then you would use oak print $2. Or if you are on the Perl school, you use Perl minus lane print $F1. And in both cases it gives you 3306. You can do the same thing if you want to know how if the result, if the replication is working. You just want a yes in this case. So to get yes, you do Perl minus lane F1 yes. So I don't know if you have heard of this Perl minus lane. I don't know you, but when I was driving in the States, I always think of this sign that I see on the street. So Perl minus lane must turn Perl. It doesn't make any sense, but this is the first thing that comes to me when I see this. So what is it? Minus lane actually is four command in one. So minus E means execute Perl code. Minus N means loop through the standard input that you get, and for each input you do what is in the this string. If you use the parse, you get what Perl understands when you do minus N E. So there is a while, define it equals argv, print whatever is in your command. Now you can simplify this using minus p instead of n. That is the same thing that we have seen before, but it will print every line unless you put a next inside. Minus l means remove the new lines from the input and put new lines in the output. So if we don't put minus L, we will not get a new line at the end of the output. If we use minus L, we will get a new line. And finally, minus A means split the line into the F array. So the F array 0 is the first value of the array. F1 is the second, in this case the array is A, B, C, so this is the second one, and C is the third one. So this is why we have Perl minus lane that I love so much. One thing that you must be aware of also is the Perl contention with the shell. When both of them use dollars, then each one of them wants to get the dollars. What happens in this case? You have $x here, and you get a syntax error. Why? Because the $x is used by the shell. So the shell will consume these 2x before they are before Perl can see the line, and it's a mistake. So if you instead use single quotes, the single quotes will prevent the shell from using it, and then Perl will use this $x and work with that. So be aware of that. Whenever you put a dollar inside your minus E command, this is what will happen to you. More techniques. Combining